Hey guys, it's me Haru, and I'm back with 5 more memorable levels, this time from Spyro 2. Now, just to clarify, these aren't my top 5 favorite levels, just popular ones based on what the fans seem to talk about most. So let's get right into it. Number 5, Scorch. Hunter's Monkey Challenge, Bombo the Flag Keeper, and of course, the twin spies with creepy powers, Handel and Greta. Of the 2 Arabian-themed levels in Autumn Plains, the other being Shady Oasis, Scorch seems to be the more favored for its NPCs, enemies, and the lack of backtracking requirements. It also has a nice color palette, as the rich golden sand really gives you the feeling of being under the blazing desert sun. But, is nobody gonna address that ending cutscene? Seriously, what was up with that? Number 4, Metropolis. Robots, space cows, and rocket pigs. Man, if you thought the enemies in Hurricos were the basis for Ratchet and Clank themselves, then Metropolis was definitely the precursor to, well, Metropolis. This level has it all. Electric floors, elevators you operate by giving yourself a concussion, an ox mini-boss you have to fight on the ice for some reason, and the very first combination power-up used to fight sheep and flying saucers. Though you'll probably be using it more to break those stupid metal chests you can't find. Number 3, Aquaria Towers. With Spyro now having the ability to swim, the inclusion of a water level was an obvious choice. I know those aren't the most favored level types in the gaming community, but if you want a good one, look no further than Aquaria Towers. The neat gimmick here is that you yourself fill the area with water as you progress, increasing your range of exploration until you reach the end and are greeted with the vast ocean above. Which makes me wonder, what did this area look like when it was dry? Number 2, Colossus. I guarantee you this is the first thing that pops into the heads of anyone who knows this level. But besides the chanting, Colossus is home to a few memorable challenges as well. Ice hockey again, chasing down a Ghastly for the professor, and the very first mini-boss, the terrifying yet- Oh wait, he gets crushed before you even take 2 steps toward him. Why is this suddenly reminding me of General Scales from Star Fox Adventures? Putting that aside though, the tranquil mountain setting and upbeat but surprisingly fitting music are very enjoyable, and can definitely put one at ease. And the number 1 most memorable Spyro 2 level is Skellos Badlands. It's on the start menu, it's on the reignited box art, Ooga, Mr. Bones, and the Lava Toads even return in Year of the Dragon. Skellos Badlands is without a doubt the most popular level from this game, and for good reason too. Not only does it present us with some unforgettable NPCs and one of the hardest 5-star challenges in the game, but it also provides a sense of nostalgia for Spyro 1. I never realized this before, but this level seems like it would have fit perfectly in the Peacekeeper's homeworld. Think about it. It already has the desert setting and dangerous liquid, just replace some of the cavemen with more enemies, and put dragons where the challenge spots should be. If anyone's planning on modding this game, please consider that. That's gonna do it for this video, guys. Let me know in the comments if these levels are memorable to you, and if you think we might see some reignited gameplay of Ripto's Rage soon. As always, don't forget to subscribe and follow me on Twitter, and I will see you in the next video. Until then, this is Miharu, signing off.